Welcome back to the Sixth Gear Garage. Today we'll be taking a look at the Vevor thermal imaging camera. So here's everything that comes with the kit. There's a quick start guide. This has everything that you need to know to start using the thermal imaging camera right away. A product certificate. Each one of these is individually inspected, so that's good for a peace of mind. And there's also a calibration certificate, so you know it's going to be accurate right out of the box. It comes with a micro SD card, 64 gigabytes, for saving photos and videos, the charging cable, and that's a USB Type-C, and the camera itself. This is model SC240M. It has a nice grip to it. This is the first time I've ever turned it on. I'll give it some time to initialize. And Vevor even includes a storage and carrying case. It has a built-in strap and even a belt loop. Okay, English, setting the date and time. And we're ready to go. But first, I'm gonna turn it back off for a minute and insert the micro SD card. And now, I'll show you how useful this tool is and why I've always wanted to own one. And I'll have a link to this in the description. So the first time I ever saw a thermal imaging camera when we first bought this house, and the home inspector had one, and he let me use it for a second. It was pretty cool because you could look into the ceiling and you could find any hot spots where there wasn't any insulation. I looked at the price of one back then, and it was almost $1,000, so I immediately wrote it off as I'd never get to own one. However, now this is only $279.99, and this does everything I could ever want it to do. So let's go through the house really quick and I'll show you why this is such a useful tool to have. Look at the ceiling here. You can see the average temperature of the ceiling is about 74, 75 degrees. And over here on the edge of the wall, we have a hot spot where we're 81.8 degrees. And this is where the insulation is thin. And this is exactly why the home inspector had one of these thermal imaging cameras. All along that edge is thin on insulation. Now let's go over here. You can see there's some spots over here. Every couple feet, we have a hot spot here, probably where there's some sort of truss or something like that on top of the ceiling. You can see we've got some heat coming in around this can light too up here. Now it also works for showing you cool spots as well. For example, the air conditioner is on right now, and you can see the actual pattern of the cold air going up the wall. Notice the green pointer is always on the minimum temperature, which is 60 degrees here, 61 degrees, and the red is always at the maximum temperature, which in this instance is 89, 90 degrees on the edge of the door there, and the white pointer in the middle is the top temperature, and that is the current reading of whatever the white pointer is pointing on. Look at this door here. You can see I've got a pretty hot spot along the bottom edge, probably have some leaking insulation along the bottom edge of the door, as well as the top up here. This is a great tool to use to go through your house and find out where you're letting heat in the summer and cold air in the wintertime. For example, I'm in this bathroom here, and you can see, once again, I have some heat coming in through the can light in the ceiling, just because the attic is above that. And in this bathroom, look how hot this is. You can see this is the vent fan in the ceiling, and it must run along up there and go up. But you can see this whole ceiling is not very well insulated. Hey, kitty. And this is an outside wall I'm looking at right now. You can actually see the studs through the wall because they transfer the heat from the outside of the house. And you'll also be able to take a look and see things that are putting out heat, such as this Wi-Fi extender here. This thing runs all the time, and look at the heat that puts out. It also lets you know that it's using up electricity all the time. Look at this air freshener. Even though it's not running right now, it's off. It is putting off heat, which means it is using electricity. And furthermore, you can look down here at the outlet it's plugged into, and you can see the adapter is warm as well. So even though this is off, it is constantly using up electricity. This is a great way to go through your house and see things that you're paying for on your electric bill that you may not even be using. Down here is an old computer, a G4, that I haven't used in months. And even though it is off, it is plugged in and it is using electricity. Here's a seal around the front door. You can see we're losing some efficiency around this for sure. Definitely along the bottom as well. So before we go out to the garage and I show you some automotive uses for this tool, let's do a quick run through of the menus. First, we have measurement where you can control the center spot. You've got your hot spot, your cold spot, or you can have nothing on there if you wish. Next, there's different view modes. Fuse, which is an overlay of what you actually see in real life combined with a thermal imaging. There's a picture in picture. And here's just the regular light. And alignment, which I'm not exactly sure what this does yet. It looks very similar to fuse, except there's a way to adjust it up to from 0.5 up to 3. There's also different palettes you can use. This was my personal favorite, but there is also one where it makes the black hot, the white cool, and an opposite which makes the white hot and the black cool. And there's one that makes the red items hot. There's rainbow HC, which makes the white areas the hottest. And there's another rainbow. And here's lava, which makes all the cool areas blue and the warm areas warm colors. And back to iron. And there's just a bunch of different settings you can go through. I'm not gonna show them all here. This is an important one. If you're in America, like I am, I chose Fahrenheit. If you're in the rest of the world, you probably want Celsius. And you can also set alerts if the temperature gets too high or too low, which is very helpful if you're monitoring something crucial. And you can adjust the scale as well of the temperature that it does read. You can see it goes all the way up to 1,022 degrees Fahrenheit. So this corner of my house is not very efficient. And I know for sure that there's no insulation in the garage, which is on the other side of this door. So let's go out there and see how it looks. Here we go. Now there's a ceiling with no insulation. And here's a kitty cat with a cool nose. So it also takes photos and videos using this trigger. Save. And if you want to do a video, do the same thing, hold the trigger down for a second. And you'll see the timer start counting, you can let go of the trigger. And when you're done, hit the trigger again, and you have the option again to save, okay. And then that will be saved in the media files here, which is on the SD card. You can load the images, and you can go ahead and look through them all. You can see all the images that I've saved. And you can play them back here, as well as take the card out and put it in your computer and access the files that way. Go back, and now we're live again. So now we're entering the pole barn, which is not insulated at all. And you can see it is 116 degrees up there, but let's do some automotive tests now. I just started the 80 series, and you can see the engine is pretty cool overall. Power steering fluid is heating up pretty fast. And there's the exhaust manifold behind the heat shield. It's already up to 220 degrees, 380 there. There's the cat, 361 at the hottest spot. I'm switching to the higher temperature scale to get a better reading on some of these hottest parts. The Mustang has been idling for a few minutes and it's getting hot in the valley between the heads behind the alternator. And way down there is a header. 560, 550 degrees. I really like that it shows the minimum and max range on the screen as well as where I'm pointing, because sometimes it's not easy to point the white reader in exactly the right spot if you're working on a tight area like an engine bay and the headers are buried. And Land Cruiser's getting hotter too, but nowhere close to the Mustang. Here's the muffler. Not as
hot as I would have thought, and the cat 245 degrees at its hottest point. Well, the hottest point that the camera sees from this angle. Back to the Mustang, I can tell the thermostat is open now because the upper hose is hot, about 140 degrees, and the radiator is up to 150. Inside I have the air conditioner running, only about 60 degrees. I hoped it would be colder than that. You can see the amount of heat that all the lit buttons and radio puts out. Let's check the ice maker. About 27 degrees. So I'm glad that still works.
This will be a real useful tool for my future videos. It even has a threaded fitting on the bottom so I can attach it to a tripod. So thanks again to Vevor for the opportunity to test and try this product. If you're interested in your own thermal imaging camera, I'll have a link to this in the description as well as a 5% discount code. I was going to show some of the recorded video footage, but I couldn't get the H.264 video files to open on my Mac. I tried two versions of QuickTime with no luck, but I'm sure there's some third-party software that will convert them to a format that a 10-year-old Mac will be happy with. My iPhone is only 8 months old though, so I figured if I shared the files to my phone, I would be able to open it. However, upon receiving the file, I was forced to go to the App Store before I was able to open it, and then I was having problems connecting to the App Store for some reason. So I gave up on opening this on an Apple product. If you have a PC, you should be good. Thanks for watching.